Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of the Daily Mat. In fact, we're going to wrap up this week with today's episode. Now, I was trying to figure out what we're going to talk about today because, of course, you know, with these ones, they're kind of short, rapid topics and just usually going to be talking about, like I said, the things that might come up between the regularly scheduled episodes that we're going to be getting started back into. Now, next week, I am going to be heading to Chicago for Woodworking in America. Can't believe that it's already here. This is going to be the design conference. Really excited about this one. I don't know how many of you have been following Chris Schwartz's blog, but it sounds like basically because we're going to be talking about topics there that really aren't something that he's that familiar with, in the sense that, you know, he's not writing articles regarding design. I mean, occasionally he'll mention them or something, but not like the way he does with hand tools. He's been referring to the fact that he's going to be like just one of the people in the audience like the rest of us, and he's really, really excited about it. It's a vacation weekend for him, which I'm sure if you follow his schedule, you know it's probably one of those well-deserved kind of a things. So it's going to be very interesting to see him in the audience alongside the rest of us, but I'm going to make sure I'm going to get footage from it. Where we're going to be doing it is just like last year. I'm going to take segments, kind of show you an idea of what it would be like to be there, but I'm not going to videotape the whole entire segments. I know many of you would prefer that I did do that, but there are some issues regarding the whole rights of the person giving the speech and infringing on like their educational rights and copyrights and everything. So that's one reason, but you know, on top of it, it's just, I think it's more interesting just to kind of get a feel for what it's like there versus seeing the whole entire lecture, because there's so many things going on. I'm going to be dodging in and out of some of the classrooms and everything just to get more of an idea of all the things that could be covered. And the neat thing is, like I said the other day, I talked about this, the way they did it, if you're not there on Friday, you know what, you can go just Saturday and just, you know, check the whole thing out and pretty much hit all the classes that you'd really want to. And remember, of course, there are still day passes available, and the vendor area, which is definitely, I'm going to get a lot of footage of that because there's going to be so many different vendors. There's a great chance to talk to some of the tool makers that we normally might be able not be able to get a hold of, and check out some of their wares and everything. The vendors area, which was originally going to be a special pass, is wide open. So if you can make it in Chicago, definitely stop by there. At least stop by the vendors area. I mean, it's going to be a huge tool show, if anything. Now, one thing I did want to talk about today, Sean Harper actually just got a hold of me last night, and he sent in a question. He was asking about the fact that I have two different dovetail saws sitting up on the pegboard here. And one of them is, of course, you probably recognize this. This is a Lie-nielsen dovetail saw. And this one pretty much is pretty obvious also, just because of this back right here. And this happens to be the Lee Valley dovetail saw. I obviously have both of them. My first purchase was the Lie-nielsen dovetail saw. And that one went with me to my very first woodworking class that I ever took at a woodcraft store, which was being taught by Christopher Schwartz, which was all about the back saws. Great class, by the way, really amazing. One thing that I've noticed with this, he was kind of asking about, like, you know, well, is there really any difference between the two of them? And this is something I'm going to be talking about coming up on one of the Just Try It Tuesdays that I'm going to be trying to put together. But, you know, there's no reason why we can't talk about it today. One thing for sure is the price point. If you have been shopping around at all, you know for a fact that the Lee Valley one comes in at, I just checked the price, was $65 on their website, and the Lie-nielsen one comes in at about $125 on its own website, on the Lie-nielsen website. So obviously the price point is huge. It's literally half of what the brass-backed Lie-nielsen one is. Now, when it comes to the handle, one thing I've noticed, I've had a chance to use both of them quite a bit, actually, at this point. I'd say I have equal time in the saddle with both of them. And the handle's, to me, very, very comfortable. In fact, I barely notice any kind of difference whatsoever when I'm holding them. It's the same exact style pistol grip. The weight of both of these saws, because I know weight sometimes becomes a real issue, especially when you're doing a lot of dovetails with it. To be honest with you, people are always like, well, this is a plastic impregnated stainless steel version, and you know, obviously it must be a little bit lighter. But in fact, I went ahead and I weighed both of these. The Lee Valley one is actually coming in about a half an ounce heavier than the Lie-nielsen one. But they're both very well balanced. The tooth configuration is almost identical. In fact, I think the Lee Valley one, oh man, I should have done the research just before I came on, has just a little bit more. I think this one is 14 PPI. In fact, it should say right on there. Oh, it's 15 PPI, and then this one is actually 14 PPI. So this was have a, just a, theoretically should have a smoother cut. The Lie-nielsen version should. But, well, let's get serious. 14, 15 PPI, it's basically the same exact cut. If I had to choose between the two of them based on function alone, that would be really, really hard. I don't know really which one I would prefer to go with, honestly. Based on price, obviously, I probably would choose the Lee Valley. One thing I like about the Lie-nielsen is that it's more of the traditional. It's a brass back. The handle is absolutely gorgeous. I mean, let's go ahead and take a look at this. It's just, it's more or less a figured maple. It's kind of like a curly maple, and it's absolutely gorgeous in there. The figure's gorgeous. With the brass, it just really makes it, it's a damn right beautiful saw when it comes down to it. I mean, even the little detail here in the handle, it's absolutely gorgeous. And it's a lot of fun to use. It really, it holds its line, starts really easy. And this is not a progressive pitch one either. But, you know, I can also say pretty much the Lee Valley one is very modern looking because of the back here, this plastic with stainless steel impregnation, I do believe is what it is. And then this is a Coca-Cola handle. And like I said, they both feel just really, really great. We'll talk more about this in the Do It Tuesdays or Try It Tuesdays coming up, because what I want to do is I'm going to do a couple of test runs where I'm actually going to use these, and you're going to see them in use, and you'll see if they bind up and everything. But when it comes down to it, which one do I prefer? That's like asking me which kid do I prefer. I love both my kids equally. They both have their own little quirks. And the same is true for the Lee Valley and the Lie-nielsen handsaws. I love them equally. They both have their own quirks and personalities. I can't choose, so don't make me. So anyways, though, but that's just a few things to think about. One last thing, and then we're going to wrap this up for this week. Like I said, it's beginning of the month, and that means that we have router bit of the month coming up. And in fact, I need to get my butt moving on this one because I still got just a little bit more footage to put together, and then we're going to get this up and running next week, actually, because next week is when we're going to start getting the show back and into its regular position. Speaking of another show, Wood Talk Online, I'm sure many of you are familiar with it. Mark and I were just talking the other day, and we've decided that rather than starting back up in the middle of August, when the two of us are going to be running around like madmen, we're actually going to do more towards the beginning of September. And we'll make sure to get the date posted much earlier so that you can check out the Wood Talk On Live episode as soon as it starts running. And that way it gives you plenty of time to make plans that night to completely ignore the family and spend it with us. So anyways, though, I think that is pretty much going to do it. I will be talking to all of you later. Straight grains and sharp blades. Have a great weekend, everybody.